So far this year, we've seen scenes like this, as floods, fires and extreme heat disrupt lives and cause huge levels of destruction. It's something we're getting used to seeing more of, not just in one region, but around the world. Floods in Western Europe in recent weeks have left tens of thousands without homes, access to power and drinking water, and more than 150 people lost their lives. The devastating impact came after some countries saw more than a month's worth of rainfall in just 24 hours. On the other side of the world, in China, roads were turned into rivers, tunnels flooded, with dams and reservoirs in danger of bursting their banks, and more than 200,000 people had to be evacuated. And from extreme wet to extreme heat, in just 2021 alone, in the US state of California, almost 5,000 wildfires have been recorded. While in Oregon, the fire has burnt an area larger than Los Angeles and is so intense that it's said to be creating its own weather system, forming clouds, thunderstorms, and even fire tornadoes. Temperatures continue to reach new extremes, with the US region of Death Valley reaching what could be one of the highest temperatures ever recorded on Earth. Heat domes in the Northern Hemisphere, where static high temperature acts like a lid on a cooking pot, has set record temperatures across three continents. In Western Canada, the heat wave has sped up the thaw of fragile glaciers that are already melting at a faster rate.
A lot of people are asking, what role do us humans play in recent extreme weather events? Scientists are saying categorically that it was almost impossible to happen, that heat wave, without the emissions from our society, our cars, our factories, our planes, our central heating, without the emissions that have driven up global temperatures. In terms of other heat waves worldwide, again, they say it is absolutely definite that heat has driven up heat waves. How could it be anything other than that?
And what about the floods? Although floods can be caused by many reasons, there can be a link.
Hot weather and hot temperatures evaporate more water vapour out of the seas. That water vapour goes into the atmosphere, and the atmosphere, being warmer, can hold more water vapour. So when it rains, there's an awful lot more water in the sky ready to come down upon us. So many questions are still to be asked and answered, but we do know that humanity has definitely played a role in making these extremes worse.
With the UK due to host COP26, a worldwide conference about climate change, there will be a lot of focus on what world leaders are going to do to help protect the planet.